Hello, praise the Lord, and God is good. And we shall always say all the time and all the time, the Lord is good. So since he's good, he has been keeping us and our safety, let us make a word of prayer, trusting God. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment again to share and hear from your word. We pray the Lord you bless us because you are our refuge, and we are going to think about that very important your attribute of our safety. And therefore, we ask you, Lord, that you bless us as we share together in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Friends, you are welcome once again to this very important moment in our life, and that is sharing God's word. And this time around, I come with a message which is actually related, like we've always had, but I come with a message, the Lord is our refuge. I just want us to concentrate on that. The Lord is our refuge. And this, the Lord being our refuge, I bring you a verse that comes from the book of Proverbs, chapter 18, verse 10. And the writer says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and are safe. The righteous run to it and are safe. And so, friends, as a believer, I have been contemplating very many things one of these days. But one of the things that keeps encouraging me in my life is the Word of God. And the Word of God cuts across, actually, right from the book of Old Testament, the books of the Old Testament to the New Testament. And now this time, this verse is one that is one of those that keeps encouraging me. Whenever there are issues that arise in my life, whenever there are issues that, you know, that disturb me, that, you know, even during good times, we have to remember this. And so I have said, remember always that the name of the Lord is a strong tower, actually fortified tower, and the righteous run to it and are safe. And so God is strength. And therefore, I come with this message, what you need to know and remember as a believer, as a Christian who believes in the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember always the name of the Lord. Remember always the name of the Lord, because, and that is his name. And as I will be explaining a little bit further, a little bit down, the name of the Lord is the name. And so he is known by his name. All of us are known by our name. You are known by your name. I'm also known by my name. But there are also some names that we get because of what we do. And so God is known the name by what he does. We know him as God the creator because he creates. We know him, the Lord God, as a deliverer because he delivers. We know him that the Lord is the savior because he saves. We know him, the Lord, as a defender because he defends. We know him as the Lord who is, you know, our redeemer because he redeems. And so the name, the Lord, the name of the Lord, know it. And we know him as the Alpha and Omega. The Bible says so. And so Alpha and Omega, because it's the beginning and the end. When he begins, we always say that he finishes. And when he finishes so well. And because he finishes so well, he gets well pleased with what he does. And so the Lord is the name. And so, not just the name, but the Bible is telling us that he's a strong tower, actually fortified. Now, something that is fortified is actually a protection. Not just that it says strong. We have seen some strong men. We have seen some strong people. We have seen some strong trees. We have seen some strong walls. But they don't protect those that are within. But our God is a strong tower. The Bible says, not just being strong, not just being having strength, but with the protective attribute in him. And so he is fortified. He's a strong tower because he protects. And now what should the righteous do then? Those who call upon the name of the Lord, what should they do? They should do this, run to it and for safety. He says, what should we do? Run to that tower and you are safe. When you are in, you are safe. When you have entered, you are safe. And the reason why we keep encouraging ourselves, brethren, I encourage you and I encourage myself that actually what we need to do is, you know, to keep in the running, to keep going, even when there are challenges, but run there and you'll be safe. Now, you run for safety. And so what more? I just want to bring you, brethren, what is this name? And I've just been reminded by myself in the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 9. And this Philippians, chapter 2, verse 9, the Bible says that therefore, we're talking about the name, remember, that therefore, God also has highly exalted him. Him is who? Jesus Christ. And given him the name, which name? Which is above every name. Yes, and that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of those in heaven and of those on the earth and of those under the earth. And then what does it say? And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Now, what name are we talking about? The name the Lord Jesus Christ. And we have always confessed that. And so, my brothers and sisters, I just want to make mention of this, because sometimes we find many, many things in life. And as believers, of course, I could have always made a prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's the name. And Jesus himself says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one ever comes to the Father except through me. And so, friends, when you talk about the name, we believers in Christ Jesus, I'm talking about that because we believe in the name, the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's the name that actually God has given him, that all knees bow down and every tongue do what? Confess. Now, in our confession is a way of running, my brothers and sisters, actually is a way of, you know, of running to it. Just confess the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and that is for your safety. And so, Jesus is the name. And for us who believe, you and me, is the source of strength. The name of the Lord Jesus Christ is the source of our safety. The name of the Lord Jesus Christ is the source of our redemption. And so, my brothers and sisters, I make mention of this today to encourage you. What are you going through? Is it something good that you are having, that you're experiencing in your life? Or is some mountain that you have to climb that is so high that you find yourself devastated? And I know there are lots of things that devastate us one of these days in our life. And then, of course, actually, our forefathers went through challenges. Yes, they did. But it seems like actually every other day it increases in magnitude. Well, they had challenges, yes, but ours also increased in magnitude, and we find ourselves, you know, our life really devastated. Now, you, young man, you, young woman, you, old person, you, mother, you, father, you, child, that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. It's the righteous that run to it and are safe. Now, what more? I just want to add another verse from Acts chapter 2. Verse 21. In Acts chapter 2, verse 21, this here what the Bible says. Acts 2, 21. About the same name. 2, 21. And the Bible says, listen to me, that, and it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now, what do I do now? Do I have any challenge? Do I have anything that is actually devastating me? Is it sickness? Well, we are still in the period of corona, and you know, many, many things are not well. Is it poverty? It's at its peak now in many homes, by the way. You find someone having nothing to eat, nothing to drink. Yes, and what more? There are so many things. Some people's marriages are on rocks. Husbands are going the other way. Wives are going the other way. Children are on their own. And, you know, I have shared with many, many people that this corona season has actually devastated more families, because men and women have kept together, husbands and wives, husbands and fathers have stayed with their children, and things are not moving. Now, listen to me, that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. So, my brethren, I just want to encourage you that, are you devastated? Are you finding life uninteresting? The name is the name of Jesus Christ. And so, as I wind up this sharing today, remember, everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And in Acts chapter 4, verse 12, the Bible still says, salvation is no one else, no another name but the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So if you are confessing the Lord Jesus Christ, if you believe in your heart, just tighten. I'm coming here to just encourage you to tighten yourself, to strengthen yourself, to keep going. That actually the issues of life shouldn't actually make you leave your faith. Don't look back. Look at me. Don't look back. Because the moment Lot's wife looked back, what happened? She became a pillar of salt. Now I'm here to encourage you that don't look back. Be strong. Be strong. Be strong indeed. And so Psalm 46, verse 1, the Bible says, the Lord is our refuge. The Lord is our refuge. And what does it say? The Lord is our refuge. And you, my brother, my sister, the Lord being our refuge. And he is our strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Those, therefore, we shall not fear, even though the earth shall be moved, and though the mountain be carried into the midst of the seas, the Lord is our strength. The Lord is our refuge. So my brethren, just in simplicity, I didn't come with any complicated message, but it is the name of the Lord is a strong tower. 46 Psalms says he is our refuge and is our strength. And as we enter into a moment of prayer, I just want us to make a reflection on Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31, and we make a prayer for ourselves, for you and me, that but those who wait on the name of the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. So I just want to encourage ourselves this day. Those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Now, we need to renew our strength much more than we have been. This is the moment for you. This is the moment for me to prove yourself as a faithful servant of the Lord in the midst of whatever you are going through, that you renew your strength. Renew your strength today in preparation for tomorrow. Renew your strength today. Mount up. I encourage you. I encourage myself. And so I make a prayer, trusting God for what he does. Those who wait on the name of the Lord shall renew their strength. And they shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not weary. Father, we thank you that you are God. And we thank you that each one that is watching and listening will benefit from this. One, we have known the name. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. And what name is that? The name is Jesus. Because above it, there's no other name that anybody can run to. And then we have said, yes, it is safety. Those who run attain safety. And so these three, four things, Father, we pray that you bless us and that we shall renew our strength. And I pray for my brethren that we renew our strength. We renew our strength. Renewing our strength in the name of the Lord. And I know that all is going to be well. Father, thank you. Strengthen us. And may we run to you for safety. And may you always be ready to receive us. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray and believe. Amen.